Assalamu alaikum. It's your Nomad Consulting here on a Friday, driving back from the mosque. Honestly, I had a nice little good session. Of course, you can't go to the mosque without actually having an element of chilling with your coffee. So I get to enjoy my nice little cappuccino right there. I ain't doing no name brand dropping because your boy ain't sponsored by them. So, but anyway, so the fact is, so today, first of all, it's been a while since I've actually been doing any video. I've just been busy with a few things, project, inshallah. Next couple of weeks, I'm going to try and give you guys some more updates. But honestly, two things that really, really, really kind of made me give me some thought in regards to, like, you know, shall I give my opinion on it, give my two cents. So, first thing I would say, and I chose this one over the other one because the other one was a bit more negative in the sense of, like, morbid wise, so I'm like, there's no point, it's a Friday. But let's talk about business wise, okay? So one lady, as I was chilling through TikTok watching a few videos, and she said, you will find when you launch your business that your client becomes your friend before your friend becomes your client. And boy, woo-hoo, that hit me deep, because you always assume when you start a business that the people around you, the people who love you, will actually support you. And also, there's this whole three F's that they say, family, friends, and fools, who are your first customers. So, but in some cases, and I'm going to look at it from both angles, okay? So first angle, I look at it at the fact that your friend or your family member knows you, who you are. Like, they might have seen you when you were a kid. They know if you're a bit of a joker, and they're like, oh, I can't really trust this person to give me that professional service or that, you know, that service. So maybe from their perspective, they don't value you enough to think that you can actually deliver the job. So that's one thing. But then comes the other side, where if you start doing well and you have strangers raving about you on Google reviews or start, like, using your services, then they say, hey, hold up. Let me try and represent and actually say, hey, what's up, Nomad? Let me use your service, but you know what? I'm your family, I'm your friend. Give me a hookup, give me a discount. And then that's, at that point, your choice if you're going to go ahead and do that. But the fact that the lady said your client will become your friend before your friend becomes your client. Of course, don't get me wrong, you have some people who take advantage of the network and would charge like $100 for a t-shirt. Come on, guys, I know you're trying to make a business, but you can't get rich overnight. So that's just kind of my thought for this Friday, that actually, if you're going to launch a business, do not get your hopes in your network thinking that you're going to get rich or get your business through your friends. Actually, in a way, a testament of your own services is if you're able to sell to a stranger and they love your product or your service, then actually, it would make sense for your own network, your own friends, to become eventual customers. Unless, of course, they have something else hidden, you know, besides that. But anyway, that's just the thing I wanted to share on this Friday. Here in Dubai, things are getting hot in the sense of, like, we're coming up to Ramadan and also summer is approaching. So all that nice kind of cool evening, I'm gonna miss it. It was my first winter here in Dubai. Even though I was busy traveling quite a lot, so I didn't get the experience as much, but I did enjoy it. But yeah, fun month coming up, holy month of Ramadan. Alright, I think I'm going to end on that note. I just want to say, I hope you guys were able to hear me over this motorway noise and the AC. But alhamdulillah, mashallah, everything is all good on my side. And like always, hopefully in March, especially with Ramadan, I'm going to be mostly in Dubai, so give me a shout. For those who want to meet up late night, of course, after iftar, definitely after Taraweeh, of course. So yeah, that's it, guys. Till next time, you take care. Peace and love. Alright.